What's up? So I'm out here messing with some stuff. I put the 33.3s on the Ace, kind of as a joke. I thought I was going to put them on the 300 and then put the 300 wheels on the Razor, but they fit pretty well and they look so good and it's got so much ground clearance. I think I'm going to leave them on there and actually test it out. They're going to rub when I hit bumps a little bit in the front and when steering, but they actually clear pretty good and it looks mean. I mean, it's got some serious ground clearance and you're probably thinking, oh, there's no way it's going to turn them, but the 325 Ace has the lowest gears of any of the Polaris's. Those are actually the same gears. Recognize that transmission looks a lot like this transmission. I put 325 Ace gears in my Razor. So yeah, pretty awesome. One thing that's weird is the Polaris ATVs have a hub-centric wheel, and it's a giant hub-centric, real round. So my little centers wouldn't fit because these wheels also fit 4x110. So luckily I had some Polaris wheel spacers in stock, threw those babies on there, good to go. Made it a little wider in the front, but it came out about even once all the suspension squatted down because the front has a little 2-inch lift. Man, it looks mean. And I think it might actually be able to turn decently and low. 27% lower. This motor makes good power. And sure, it's going to get bogged down real thick stuff, but just for like putting around and some little ruts and stuff, probably all right. I'm not going to take anything crazy. 300, yeah, I didn't do anything with that today because I got sidetracked. I am going to put some spring spacers on the front. See how the front of this thing kind of sags? It could really sit 2 inches higher, maybe 2.5 inches higher, a lot higher. Just to make that work, I got to get some Z-bent tie rods. Talk to Jason Laws about that, so he can hook me up with some. No big deal, but yep. But the problem is, I didn't have any wheels mounted up that would clear my brake rotors on the Razor. And I've got to get the Razor back into the backyard, obviously. So I put it on my Ford Focus wheels, and I'm going to try to drive it into the backyard. Backyard's kind of a lake right now. You see the puddle over there. We had a bunch of rain. So it's got no traction, but it does have a locker in the front and full-time, you know, real four-wheel drive. So I expect to get a little bit of wheel spin, but I think it might actually make it into the backyard. We'll do a little video. Four-wheel drive, definitely needed. All right, let's see how she does. That's how you cut your water hose right there. Guess we'll use low range. Oh yeah, not a problem. I don't guess I'll be getting any momentum. Gotta cut through my neighbor's yard a little bit. He's gonna love this. Now we're getting to the real mud. Ooh, I might get high center. Let's just hit the middle of the puddle, why not? Yes! Very interesting handling characteristic. It makes a very interesting pattern too. Alright, put it in high and you'll burn out. It worked much better than expected. I bet we could whip some sick donuts in two-wheel drive. Yeah, you can't whip any sick donuts because it barely moves in two. That is hilarious. Surprised how well this works. Oh, I didn't have any wheels to put on it. I'm tilling the yard. Check it out. Oh no! I'm stuck! It's not gonna hurt the wheels, they're off of Ford Focus, so they can handle anything. Very. In two-wheel drive, it doesn't even move. It doesn't even move in two. Well, that was highly successful. It did do a little bit of damage to my yard. It looks like a train drove through here or something. Very interesting tread pattern. Very nice. Someone commented on the video of the Ace and asked if I had gotten water in the oil. So I figured I would make a video. Not in the oil, but you see the air box is, air filter's real nasty and there's some water underneath it. But this is where the crankcase breathes and it's got one of those little duck bills on it. So it's almost like a one-way valve right there on the crankcase breather. It goes up here into a little diaphragm box here, the hose goes in there. And then after that, it goes around the back onto the motor where it breathes on the crankcase. So it would be really hard to get water in this bike, even stock, because the water has to come in here through the first little air box, through the pipe, fill up the air box completely up to this, and then has to get past the little breather, and then has to go up and then get past that. So this design is very, very hard to get water in the oily. Very cool. But yeah, man, this thing looks super sweet. Dude, 33.3s on an Ace 325. Should be interesting.